Hello everyone, I'm a Dr. Mohal Banker, intervention radiologist from Ahmedabad, and today I'm going to discuss very interesting case of left to right venous stent. This patient has a thrombosis into the left iliac vein stent, and because of this total blockage into the left iliac vein, its entire venous drainage of the left lower limb goes from left to right to through this venous shunt, and the right iliac vein carries left lower limb venous drainage also along with the right lower limb venous drainage. So this is really interesting and amazing case. Let's have a look on its clinical history and other findings. So this is a 55 years old patient, and he has a history of unproductivity left lower limb 10 years back. And after that, into CT venography, it was detected that there is a Mathurner syndrome, there's stenosis into the left iliac vein. So 5 years back, he went for left iliac vein stenting, and later on, his all the complaints disappeared. But right now also, patient has no symptoms, no pain, no swelling, nothing else. But he is just complaining about this left lower abdominal wall dilated, these venous channels, and gradually it is increasing when he comes into the follow. So right now he's only complained about this lower abdominal wall varicosity. Otherwise, patient does not have any pain nor swelling into the left lower limb. So let's have a look on its color Doppler finding. So here is a 2D images, 2D video, and the same 2D video is available on the with the color Doppler over here. So basically, this is a left iliac artery, and you can see that this pulsation over here, and below it there's a left iliac vein. You can see this bright boundary of this left iliac vein. There is a stent, and within the stent, with the low PRF mode also, there was no color flow detected within the stent. So this is a classical case of left iliac vein stent thrombosis. Patient has gone through this left iliac vein stenting 5 years back, but right now there was no significant flow detected into this left iliac vein stent. Similarly, over left hand side, here this is a 2D image, and on the right hand side this is a color Doppler image. This is a left subfemoral junctions, and left subfemoral junction shows reflux into the resting phase, and from this left SF junction, this is when I go little bit cranially and towards the right side, these all the bunches seen over here. This is all the lower limb, a lower abdominal wall varicosity, which is classically seen over here, and this shows the during the valsalva there's a reflux seen into this varicosity. So gradually my probe goes from the left side over here to the right side, and gradually all this lower abdominal wall varicosity is very well visible on this color Doppler, and I try to trace the shunting when these where these all connect, these collateral is connected. So these on the right side, these right femoral artery and veins, and when I press these right subfemoral junction, the all, so these are shunting area, these collateral joints into these right great subfemoral vein near the junction, and there is a great saphenous vein on the right side which is not dilated. So ultimately there is a left to right shunt because of the left iliac veins stent thrombosis. Entire drainage of the venous system on the of the left lower limb goes from the left side to the right side through all these collaterals, and from this right iliac vein it goes towards the IBC. So right iliac vein carries venous drainage of the right lower limb also, and from the left lower limb also, and because of that These dilated channels are visible into the lower abdominal wall of the patients. So thank you so much for listening to this interesting case. If you have any queries, just ask me any question. Let me know if I will try to solve all the queries.